so deep in the University of Logan's Bush, you'll find what British scientists have recently discovered. A new species of orangutan known as Homo erectus, Ethanus coshatus. After his daily ritual of twiddling and twirling throughout the ferns, you can observe him basking in the sun as he fondles the cloacas of dandelions and works on his perfect tan. You will often find him feeding on roots, chipmunks, 7-Eleven Slurpees, and his main food source, plants.
Plants, ledge plants, any sort of plant. But I'm going to be teaching it to you with the trick of flat top. Bam. The first thing you need to know is foot position. So you're going to have your back foot, my left hand, my left foot, on the tail like so, with a lot of the toes hanging off so you can hit the ground easily. And then you're going to have your front foot in about the middle of the board. It doesn't really matter, but the middle makes it easier. And so with that back foot on the tail like this, what you can do is when you pop it up, your foot will step on the ground automatically and kick the board out in front of you, making it easier to grab. Alright, next important thing is the grab. What you're going to do is you're going to grab with your front hand. For me, since I'm goofy, it's going to be my right hand. And you're going to grab on the toe side edge of the board, which for me is on the left side of the board. So you're going to grab up near the front truck, but not too close. About right here, a couple inches away, is really good. So you're going to grab it like so, your thumb pointing down. So that way you can rotate the board and make it do a 180. Yeah. Alright, so the third step. What you're going to do with your front foot is it's going to step to the toe side edge of your board. So for me as a goofy rider, it's going to step to the left. So I'm going to pop the board up, I'm going to grab it here on the toe side edge as well with my right hand. I'm going to have my right foot step to the left side of the board. And from here, this is your jumping leg. Your front leg is your jumping leg. So you're going to bend that knee and hold that board like so, with your thumb pointing down, and jump off of it as you turn to the right if you're goofy, you turn to the left if you're regular. So you're on that knee, nice and bent, and you rotate and jump. And make the board do a 180 like so. Like this. All right, and once you have the board 180'd and you're ready in the air and you have your left leg hiking up towards your chest for extra height, you're just gonna spot your landing on your board and land square. Bam! Like that. Bam. Alright, so what I taught you was the flat ground flat top. So it only takes two steps. Now to do it up a ledge, what you can do is do the same two steps. One, then two. And as you jump and pull the board upwards with your back foot, you're gonna step it onto the ledge and jump off that. First step, second step, and then that back leg is gonna plant on the ledge or whatever. And there, you're gonna jump off of it. Now, when you're jumping off, you wanna hike your knee up, so it gives you a little extra height, gives you some more air time, so you can figure out when you're gonna land, or where you're gonna land on your board. Wait. Never mind. All right, so jumping off ledges is pretty easy, because you jump upwards and like over it. Now, to jump off a wall, you kinda have to plant your foot sideways and jump away from it. So you come at it, smack it, and then jump off, like this. Alright, so wall plants are a little bit different. You do generally the same thing. You do your flat top approaching the wall at a pretty decent speed. But when you pop it up and then you jump off, what you're gonna wanna do is turn around like so, do that 180, jump off, and then plant that foot as high as you can. And not only push outwards, but kind of push upwards too. If you push too straight up, you're just gonna slip and fall down. So when I do it, I usually slap my hand on the wall for not really any reason. Maybe it gives me a little bit more push, I guess, like outwards, but it also just kind of looks cool. Maybe you can have a sticker in your hand and stick slap, and then push off. So yeah, that's good. Okay, so the reason I chose to teach you guys how to do the flat top is because there's tons of variations. You can finger flip it, you can do a full 360, or you can have the board do a full 360. Like, there's so many different possibilities. Like, you could change your feet when you plant. You could plant with your back foot, or your front foot instead of your back foot. Or you could even grab with your back hand instead of your front hand. There's so many different possibilities that you can do with this trick that it's just one of my favorites because you can do it off of anything and pretty much anywhere. Alright guys, well that's how you do the wall plant and ledge plant flat top. It's a really fun trick, you can get a lot of air with it, look pretty cool. Tons of variations, but it is pretty dangerous, so it's good to wear knee pads, elbow pads will definitely help. And gloves can help too, but it can make it kind of hard to grab your board, so you're just going to have to get your way around that. It's not too hard, I just put my butt back. But anyways, stay safe and stay steezy. Bye. I have switched. I have switched.